Overleaf is a great online tool that allows you to write and compile LaTeX documents. You can use it for free, and in order to use it, you can access it via any web browser. So the first thing that you need to do is to register a new account if you don't have one, or to log in into your existing account. After you log in, you will be prompted with this screen here, and you can see that here in the center, you have all the projects and papers that you have been working on, and on the left, you have a navigation bar. In the navigation bar, you can see archive projects shared with you, and you can also create folders to organize your project. For instance, here I've created two folders, one called paper and the other one tutorials. If you want to create a new project, it's super simple. You can click here, new project, and in this case, we are going to create an example project. However, you can also upload a project from a zip file, you can import a project from GitHub, or you can browse through templates for journals, books, letters, and so forth. Let's start with an example project. We just have to give a name. We're going to call it YouTube example, and then we're going to press on create. Overleaf automatically created the project for us and has compiled the document for us. In this video, I'm not going to explain anything in detail about LaTeX. This video is just an overview on how to use Overleaf. If you want to find out how to add section, images, table, bibliography, and many other things to your LaTeX document, just check my LaTeX playlist or my Beamer playlist. In this video, I'm just going to focus on the main functionalities of Overleaf. So Overleaf is divided in three tabs, one here on the left, one here in the center left, and one here on the center right. On the right side, we have the paper in PDF. This is how your paper or presentation is going to look like, and this is the final compiled PDF document. Here on the center left side, we have the LaTeX source code that you can edit to change your document. A very nice functionality that we get straight out from the box is that if we look into our PDF here and we want to change some text, we can just simply double click on the text that we want to change, and we can edit here on the center left in the source code. And for instance, we can type this green frog. We can recompile the document either by clicking here at the top or pressing Ctrl Enter. You can navigate from the code to the PDF also using this arrow here. At the top, we can see that we have a chat where you can chat with different collaborators. So you can just leave messages here for other collaborators. You have history, which is very nice because you can see and you can track all the changes that you have made. For instance, here is telling us that we have edited the main.txt file, and we can compare it with a previous version by clicking here at the top, compare to another version, and it shows all the changes that we have made. For instance, we added this word green here to the document. You can also download the project a different version. So if you want to click here on the previous version, on the original one, you can also download the project at this specific version. This could be handy if you made a lot of changes to your document. Let's go back to our main view. We can click here at the top and we can submit our paper. I never use this functionality, but you can use this button to directly either publish your document in an Overleaf gallery. And this is very nice if you have, for instance, created a template that you want to share with other people, or you can also share your paper to some specific journal, for instance, IEEE journal. You can share the project with the collaborators. So you can either turn on link sharing and send them the link to the paper. Alternatively, you can share it with collaborators by adding their email here and then clicking on the share. You can also control what they can do. You can select whether they are read-only or they can also edit your document. Finally, you can activate the review tab here. And next time that you're going to make a change, if track changes is on, Overleaf will mark that change as a track change. So for instance, let's click here at the top. Let's enable track changes for everyone. And we are going to change this word to documents. As you can see here, in this middle pane here, now we have track changes. So we can see who did the change. This is me. If you have other collaborators in the project, then here is going to appear their name. And then later on, we can accept or reject this change. We can also leave comments here. So we can select some text, and then we can add a comment. And we can say, change this. And then we can leave a comment. Other authors may then address, or later on we can go back to this comment and we can address it. We can write a reply here, or we can hit on resolve. If you click on resolve, we can still access all the resolve comment via this menu here. And here it shows us what was the comment. We can reopen this comment, or we can just delete it. Here at the top, you can also toggle between source. So here we can see the source code, so the LaTeX source code, or the rich text. The rich text mode may be handy for those of you or for those people which are not very familiar with LaTeX, so it provides like a rich text view, and you can edit the document as if it was a Google Doc or a Word document, so it's a little bit easier to use. However, I would suggest you to just use and stick with the source code if possible, if you're not a reviewer, because you can have access to much more functionalities. Here from the top, we can also download the PDF. So here, if I click here, as you can see, I've downloaded the PDF on my computer, and then I can open it with any PDF viewer. And I can see also the view logs here at the top, and I can see if there were errors or problems. If you know that everything is okay, but you are experiencing an error, sometimes it might be useful to clear the cache files here at the bottom. Let's go back to View PDF, and let's see the left navigation bar. So here at the bottom, we have the file outline, which is very nice because we can navigate through different sections and subsections. So this is very handy to navigate through our document, while here at the top, we can see all the files that are inside our document. Of course, we can create new folders called figures, and then I'm going to hit on create, and then I can move and upload the figures inside here. So how can I upload a figure inside here? I can click on the upload button, and then I can select a file from my computer, and I'm going to upload a thumbnail for my video. Now that my image has been added, I can add it to the document, so I can replace the picture of the frog with a new uploaded image. And Overleaf is quite handy, because I just have to type the name of the file, and automatically will detect in which subdirectory it is, and will add it to my document. So let me recompile the document, and we should be able to see the image here. Of course, you can create other folders where you're going to store different sections of your document, or tables. You can also create new files. For instance, if you want to create a BIB file, or if you want to create a text file or a README, you can do so from there. We have the menu button at the top here, which is very handy because we can copy the project, we can use the word count, and we can count how many words we have already written in our document. We can sync with Dropbox, Git, and GitHub. Check my video on how to do that. I've already uploaded another video. You can change the compiler. You can select a different main document to be the source file from your text document, which Overleaf is going to compile. You can select the different languages for the spell check, and so forth. Finally, from here, if you want to go back to the main Overleaf page, you can just click here on this arrow here at the top. And this will bring you back to the page where you can see all your projects. And by clicking on the project, you are redirected back to it. I really hope you found this video interesting. If you did, please consider liking my video and subscribing to my channel. If you want to support my channel, you can buy me a coffee. More information down in the video description below. And if you want to learn more about LaTeX, check my LaTeX playlist. I also have a playlist on Beamer. Thank you very much for listening, and see you next time.